We have a green screen. We've just bought a green screen, so we're quite obsessed with it. I am Grace Farrell, and you are unfortunately watching The 86th Floor. Today I'll be discussing episode 6 of Channel 4 and AMC sci-fi series Humans. This review will contain spoilers, so go and watch it if you haven't already. I feel like we really made a lot of headway in this episode. The different strands of the story are starting to come together to make way for the penultimate and final episodes. The Elster secret is out, Mia's back, and we know how and why each conscious synth was created. Plus, we know the story of Leo's death and resurrection. The only spanner in the works is that bloody Joe Hawkins has alerted the police to their whereabouts, and as a result, the most moving and nail-biting scene that we've seen so far has taken place, namely Max jumping into the river, effectively killing himself. His most poignant words were, "If I die, it means I've lived," sort of reaffirming what Dr. Millikan said earlier, that the concept of life is essentially defined by death. All living things die, which is what makes them alive in the first place. So, to run through the synths, because we now know their family history. Leo was Elster's biological child. Mia was made first to look after Leo because his own mother couldn't. And then came Fred and Niska, and finally Max, who's Leo's little brother. Oh. There's a strong message that seems to run through this episode, and that is that we're all shaped by our experiences, and that in turn affects our attitude towards other people. Niska reveals to Millicent that she was sexually abused by Elster, and that, coupled with her days as a synth prostitute, has made her really bitter towards humans, particularly, it seems, towards men. By the way, Niska, I'm sorry for being mean about you in my last review. I hope you'll forgive me. Max, on the other hand, has always been shown love by Leo, hence his optimistic nature. By the way, how adorable was that scene where he prays? I love Max. Fred, on the other hand, has been held prisoner by humans, so now he's gone on a shooting spree. And Mia, having lived with the Hawkins family, I mean, although they're not perfect, she kind of feels that she can trust her humans, perhaps not others, but definitely the Hawkins. Laura's secret is also out. We now know that Tom was her brother, I knew it, and why she kept him a secret all this time. To be honest, I don't think this is the end of Laura's family story, because it just seems too unrelated to the series. I mean, why would Laura have such an apparently significant backstory if it wasn't going to somehow affect the synth plot? I think Laura's family narrative is one to watch. If you have any theories on this, by the way, please post them below. The only major thread of the storyline that's still completely unexplained is Karen Voss. Who is she? Who created her? Why is she conscious? There's so many questions. Hopefully, episode 7 will give us a bit of insight there. Now, the last character I'll mention is Hob, because he became pretty important in this episode. At the very beginning, we saw him with Fred, and he revealed that he didn't want to kill Fred because that would mean trying to, in his words, hold back future itself. He refers to his pacemaker and says that that's a machine inside a human, and that Fred is a human inside a machine, and that the two things aren't really that different. The lines are blurry. So he wants to continue Elster's work and create a coming together of humans and machines on a greater level. So it'll be interesting to see ultimately what Hobbes' objective is with Elster's synths, and whether he's good or evil, or just neither. Till next time, YouTubers, when we'll be looking at the all-important penultimate episode. Let us know what you think in the comments below and subscribe for more British sci-fi videos. By the way, very exciting news for humans today, because it's just been revealed that there's going to be a second series. Hello, I'm Grace Farrell, and this is the 86th Floor YouTube channel. We're now past the halfway point.